Hello there. Welcome to yet another wonderful day with me, Bishop Mike Lodge, on Daily Word and Prayers. I come your way today declaring over your life that the Almighty God will be as a mighty, terrible one against all that persecute you and all that stand against your glory. And I speak over you and declare, by the strength of this God of heaven, whom you call upon, you shall run over a troop and you shall leap over every wall of hindrance in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. No hand of the wicked shall stand against you to prosper. Every tongue lifted up against you in judgment, I condemn them in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I release grace for a greater tomorrow. I release grace for a blessed life. I release grace for honor and glory in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You will testify of the goodness of the Lord God Almighty in the land of the living in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Today we'll be continuing from whence we stopped yesterday. Still looking at the I am-ness of the Lord Jesus Christ. He said, I am come that ye might have, life and have this life abundantly. Today we'll be looking at the fact that he has come to give us not just only the things we have discussed before now, but that we might see that we can have whatsoever we say based on whatsoever we believe. Because it is your belief that determines your confessions, which are your words. So whatever you see as an external reality, it's a combination of what you have believed in your heart and what you have confessed with your mouth. I pray that you give me your listening ears, even in a time like this. God bless you as I go through the scriptures that we're going to look at today in Jesus' name. For a text, I want us to look at Mark's Gospel, chapter number 11, reading verse number 23. It says, for verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he said shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he said. Hallelujah. That's heavy. He shall have whatsoever he saith. Now, looking at yet another scripture in the book of Matthew's Gospel, chapter number 9, reading from verse number 27 through to number 30. Scripture says, and when Jesus departed thence, two blind men followed him, crying and saying, thou son of David, have mercy on us. And when he was coming to the house, the blind man came to him. And Jesus said unto them, believe ye that I am able to do these? They said unto him, yea, Lord. Then touched he their eyes, saying, according to your faith, be it unto you. And their eyes were opened. My God. In John's Gospel, which is the third scripture we are going to be looking at, chapter number 1, reading verse number 1 through to 5, scripture records, in the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, And without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and darkness comprehended it not. What a word. And the last scripture we'll look at is in 2 Corinthians chapter number 4, verse number 13. And it says, we, having the same spirit of faith, according as it is written, I believed, and therefore have I spoken. We also believe, therefore we speak. I pray that the opening of my mouth will be as the pen of a ready writer, and that the truth of God's word will come upon us, precept upon precept, line upon line, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord says to say to every one of us under the sound of my voice, that your external realities are nothing but the function of your internal positionings. The state of your belief in your mind determines what your mouth confesses, and what your mouth confesses is what you see in life as a reality. Scripture says that all things are possible to him that believes. Out of your possibility mindset, your mouth begins to speak. And whatever your mouth speaks, which is a possibility, your life begins to experience. So if I want to change my external realities, all I need to do is first change my mental positioning, change my mindset, which is establishing my belief systems, and then my mouth will begin to confess also something different, and my life will begin to experience something definitely different from what I've been experiencing. If I believe that I am not poor, I will never say with my mouth that I am poor. Rather, I will say I am rich. And if it syncs with what my mind has said, my hands will begin to see riches, and my life will begin to experience riches. So you can be whatever you want to be if you believe you can be it. You can get whatever you desire to get and believe you can get if your mouth also can confess it. And above all, you can achieve whatever you want to achieve if you can but believe it and your mouth confesses it. But you know what the problem is? Many of us say things that our minds do not actually believe in. That's why we don't get the things we ought to get. And most times our mouth confesses so negatively that it destroys the blessings and the creativity that God has established for us to have. Please hear this and hear me very well. Scriptures in the book of Mark 11 says, whosoever shall say to this mountain. What's a mountain? A mountain is an extended earth that is projected from the normal surface of the earth's soft level, which means a mountain can represent a problem. A mountain can represent what you call a hindrance, a barrier. A mountain can represent that which hinders you from making progress. A problem, a hindrance, a barrier. But you see, you did not create the mountain, but you can speak to the mountain. You can speak to that mountain in your life to live, and it will live if you believe that it will live. Most times we look at the mountain and we doubt what we can do by our belief system and by our spoken words. Jesus' word will never return unto him void. He said, if you or me, whosoever shall say to this mountain, it's a particular mountain, whatever it is, this one that is bothering you, this mountain that's a problem, this mountain that's an issue, this mountain that's bringing you shame and disgrace, this mountain that's making you not to know progress, increase in life, this wicked mountain that's keeping you on this side of life, when you ought to have gone to the other side of life. He said, if you can say to it, be thou removed, and be cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in your heart, that in your mind, but believe that those things which you say shall come to pass. He said, you shall have whatsoever you say. Now please hear this. What you say is connected to what you believe. So if there is a problem with what you believe, what you say will be affected. Again, I'll say it. What you say is a product of what you believe. So if what you believe is affected, what you say also will be affected. That's why the Bible says, let not a double-minded person, a person who believes now and does not believe the next minute, let him not think he can receive anything from the Lord. So if your heart is shaky, if your mind is shaky over any matter, in the area of believing at one time and not believing after another time based on the things you are experiencing, you will not get what you need to get. You will not have it. So this is what the Lord says we should say. Believe it, say it. If you don't believe it, you don't say it. Because if you don't say it, it means what you believe will never find expressions upon the face of the earth. The passage we read concerning the two blind men, it says, they cried to Jesus, have mercy on us. Then Jesus asked them, do you believe that I am able to do this? He wanted to hear their belief. I didn't say he wanted to see it. He wanted to hear their beliefs. So it means whatever you believe, your mouth will always declare. Whatever you believe, your mouth will always reveal it. He said, believest thou that I'm able to do this? And they spoke their beliefs by saying, yes, we believe you are able to do this. And scripture says, he touched their eyes and said to them, according to your faith, be it unto thee. Which means, I really am not the one that made it happen. Your faith made it happen. Your faith made it happen. What you believe and what you said made it happen. I am speaking to you under the sound of my voice. And I say, what you say based on what you believe will make you have all that your heart desires in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, let's get into the nitty-gritty of all I'm talking about. A young boy, having heard this, saying, whatsoever you say to a mountain, the mountain will respond to you if you believe it. He saw a mountain in front of his house, not too far away, big mountain. And he said, I want to prove this word of the Lord. So from his room, he started stretching out his hands and speaking to the mountain. Mountain, I command you to move in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Be removed from here. I command you to be removed from this place. Mountain, in Jesus' name, move. He said that the first day, nothing happened. The second day, nothing happened. The third day, nothing happened. 1 month, nothing happened. 2 months, nothing happened. 3 months, he did not doubt one day what he was saying. That he kept seeing the mountain did not stop him from saying that the mountain should move. Hear this. After a while, about from 3 months, he had to go on a journey, on a trip that took him some months, some 6 months. When he returned back to his home, the mountain was no longer there. And you ask me what happened? In the place of the mountain, there was a good road, an expressway. Let me tell you what this did, what God did rather. While he was speaking to the mountain to move, creative force went into action and went to the persons that had the ability to take the mountain out, went to the government officials who wanted to make a road, and all of a sudden they decided that the road should pass through that place where the mountain was. They could have taken the mountain, the road by the side of the mountain, but somewhere along the line, they just felt, well, what's this mountain really doing here? Let's knock it off. So they blew the mountain out of the way and put a wonderful road through that place. Did what the boy say come to pass, or it didn't come to pass? It came to pass. All he did in making the mountain to move was to speak. And what God did in making the mountain to move was to use the creative words that he had spoken to go forth into action, creating an environment by which that which he has spoken will find expression. Government officials went into action and the thing became a reality. As I speak to you right now, every word that comes out of a mouth will find expression upon the face of the earth. If your mind, your heart believes it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. What is it that you want God to move out of your life? What is it that you want God to do for you? What do you want to have? It says, believe it and say it. Whosoever shall say to this mountain, be thou removed, and shall not doubt in his heart, but believe that whatsoever he saith shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he saith. If you read that passage of scripture, we find that say it came up three times. Believe is established once. So whatever you believe, you must consistently, repeatedly declare with your mouth. Because what your mouth says is a reflection, is a mirror of your heart and your belief. My God, my God. Let me share this with you. It's a secret to scriptures. The Bible says, in the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God. And the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by Him. And without Him was not anything made that was made. Now let's hold it there. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was God. Which means Word is God. Word is God. Word carries God's potentials, God's I am-ness, God's power, God's enablements. What your word declares becomes the God that your life experiences. Kalabateke shupalikas. I'll say it again. What your mouth declares becomes the God that you experience. The God of scripture is the God of possibility. So every time your mouth declares negativity, that's not the God of scripture. That's the God that you created over yourself by what negative words you spoke. Listen to this. There are two reasons for which the word was released and word was established by God. Two reasons. One, creation. Two, communication. Two reasons for which words were created by God. One, creation. Two, communication. Many of us operate using words only for communication, not knowing that words, which is the primary essence for which God made the word or used the word, was for creation. That's why the Bible says that all things were made by Him, and without Him, the Word was not anything made that was made. So if you want to make your world, you make your world by your Word. And your Word is a product of your belief system. Your belief system. That's why we must not joke with words. Every careless, idle word we speak, we shall give account of them before the Lord. This is one thing I want you to realize. Word is so powerful that it is what established creation upon the face of the earth. And God could not identify himself with any other thing than the Word, than Word. God says, I am the Word, I am Word. So hear this. Every man's existence upon the face of the earth is by words. Every man's realities externally is by words. You are what you are by words. Either the words you have spoken or the words somebody else spoke over you. So what you have to show for life is a product of words. Is a product of words. And words are a product of your belief systems. My God. Hear this. Scripture says, the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the deep. The earth was without form. It was empty. And darkness was upon the face of the deep. When the Spirit of God moved in taking assessment of all that he saw, the reaction of the Almighty was in words. In words. Not in emotions. Not in weepings. But in words. It says in chapter 1 and verse 1 of the book of Genesis, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. Verse 2, the earth was without form. It was void. Darkness was upon the face of the deep. Three negative things happened to the earth that he, God, had created. And you and I know that if you create something, it will always have a form, which is a shape. It will always carry something. It will not be empty. And it will not have darkness because God is light. But all these negative things happened to the earth God created. God did not weep. He didn't show emotions. Rather, he spoke. And he spoke what he wanted to see, what he wanted to have. And the first thing he said, let there be light. And there was light. He had light. Because what his mouth declared was what he believed. And there was light. Let there be a firmament in the heaven, and it was so. Let the firmament have this and that, it was so. Let the waters have this and that, it was so. What he called into existence by words were the things that found expressions in the world. What finds expression in your world, in your life, is basically tied to the words that come out of your mouth. For every word that comes out of your mouth is the God you experience upon the face of the earth. That becomes your utmost realities and nothing else. So hear me, and hear me real good. Look at what Paul was saying in 2 Corinthians chapter number 4, verse number 13. We, having the same spirit of faith, which means the same spirit of belief, knowing that it's our belief system that creates our realities externally. We have the same spirit of faith. The faith that calls those things that be not as though they were. I believe that these things will happen. And so it becomes a reality. It says, because we have the same spirit of faith, according as it is written, I believed, and therefore have I spoken. I believed, therefore have I spoken. So me speaking is a function of my belief. And it says, we also believe, therefore we speak. So please, therefore, never speak what you don't believe. If you speak, let it be as a result of what you have considered diligently to be something you believe, something you have accepted as true, something you have accepted as right. Then you can speak it. Because many of us have spoken things we do not accept in our hearts. But God says, from today, if we begin to accept that we are blessed and our mouth speaks it, not minding what we see externally, then we will see the reality of being blessed. Wake up every morning and begin to speak your belief. Call it into existence. Call it. You see, when the Bible says weeping may endure but for the night, joy cometh in the morning, it means while the weeping was going on, somebody was calling joy to come. Because joy never comes except somebody calls it. Come! It means I called you to come, then you begin to respond to my call. Which means everything your heart desires, if you can but speak it, it will begin to respond to you by the strength of the grace of heaven. I really don't intend to take your time and to keep you too long in a day such as this. But hear this and hear me real good. As I share with you this very little testimony of a young boy who came to believe, something that rather appeared impossible considering the state of life he was in at that particular time. A young boy came to church, and while the church service was going on, prophetic words were being released. Thus saith the Lord, I'm releasing cars. Receive your car. Receive your car. Receive your car. And the young boy said, amen, I believe. I believe. He did not consider his status. He did not consider his financial positioning. He did not consider his educational background. But he just believed that if God can say it, then he can receive it. That if God says he's releasing cars, he too can have a car. So he says, I receive it and I believe it. And he went and sowed a seed on the altar of the Lord. We call that the amen seed. He kept releasing amen seed, saying, I believe I have my car. I believe I have my car. The next day, he went to work. And this young man was a cleaner. He was a cleaner in an office, in an organization. And when he got into the office the next day, he was full of joy and just started singing while he was cleaning the office very early in the morning. As he went on cleaning, his boss came into the office, and the boss noticed that this young man was full of joy and he was laughing. And the boss asked a question. Joe, he said, good morning, sir. He said, yes, sir. I see that you are kind of happy today. What's the matter? The boy laughingly said, sir, I'm happy because I have a car. His mouth spoke what his heart believed. His mouth declared what his mind believed and accepted as true. Can I tell you what? The boss said, wow, if indeed you have a car, come and show me your car. Where is the car? You are a cleaner. How come you have a car? It must be a miracle. Show me the car. And Brother Joe, which was his name, said, I have it by faith, sir. I have it by faith. Because yesterday when the word of God came, I believed that I have the car. And the man looked a little bit puzzled and said, you have it by faith? He said, yes. You don't have it physically? He said, yes, sir, but I have it by faith. And the man got a little bit offended. I said, what nonsense is that? And while he was getting offended, the boy began to laugh in the spirit. The spirit of laughter took over him. And as he was laughing, the man felt more offended that the boy was laughing at him. And he said, Joe, is it that you are laughing at me or what? The boy laughingly also said, sir, I'm not laughing at you. I'm just laughing. I'm excited. And the man said, I can't see myself laughing. So if I'm not laughing, it means you're not laughing with me. You are laughing at me. The boy just kept on laughing. And strangely, as it may seem, the spirit of the Almighty God took hold of the boss of this young boy. And he changed his countenance and he asked Joe a question. Do you think I cannot buy you a car? Oh, is that why you are laughing at me? You think I can't buy you a car? Oh, I get it now. You're actually laughing, thinking I can't buy you a car. I will prove to you today that I can buy you a car. The boy just kept on laughing. And the man was dead serious. Took hold of the boy and said, follow me right now. Get into the car. They got into the car. And the man drove him to a car lot and said, choose anyone you want and I'll buy it for you to prove to you I can buy you a car. You are laughing at me that I can buy you a car? What's a car? Brother Joe picked one and the man paid for it. Brother Joe came to church the next week with a car, rolling the car keys around his finger and was giving praise and thanks to God. Why? He got what his mouth spoke based on what his heart believed. I don't know who it is that is under the sound of my voice. He says, you shall have whatsoever you say based on whatsoever you believe. You shall have whatsoever you say based on what you believe. Hear me. Men create their own destinies by their belief systems. Your experience in life is tied to your belief and your confessions. Stop thinking that this is how life will end for you. Create for yourself a new world. For the world we live in was created by the spoken word. The world you want to see and experience, you can experience, you can have, if you can create it first in your mental state, in the mental state, in your mind. Create it, believe it, and speak it. The place where creativity takes place is in your mind. It's called the power of imagination, originality of thought, of the way you want your life to become, what you want to see and have. Believe it. And speak it. Do not worry yourself over how it will come to pass. There are many things that you do that you don't know how they come to pass. Now, I want to ask, do you drive a car or you don't drive a car? If you drive a car, do you know how a car functions? What you are told is get in behind the steering, start the ignition, put it on gear, and you start going. As you press your leg on the throttle. That is it. You want it to stop, you press the leg on the brakes. You want it to turn to the right or the left, you turn it and it turns. The mechanism by which all this happens, you know nothing about them. It's been programmed for you to operate. You want your lights in the house to come on, all you need to do is press a switch. And the light comes on. You want it to go off, press another switch, and it goes off. The mechanism by which current travels from one spot to another, you know nothing about it, but you just see light because you obey by doing what is necessary. So also, I say to you, to see a great reality of possibilities, of favor, breakthroughs, blessings, all you need to do is believe for it and speak it out. If you do this, you will see and have whatsoever you say in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Please never forget, what you believe and say about any and every circumstance is what it becomes and is what you get. And that is what your external reality is all about. So it means I can change my world. I can change the group of persons I have around me. I can change the kind of way I live my life. I can change the things I begin to have. I don't need to change it from the external. I need to change it from the internal, from my mind. That's why I've been talking about mindmatics. Mindmatics. The systematic relationship that exists between the informations we receive, which we put in our mind, and our thoughts, our belief systems, our attitudes, and our actions. So please, I came to say to you here, all things are possible. All things are possible to him that believes. And I add to it, to him that believes and speaks. For with the heart, which is the mind, man believes. But with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. So salvation is not complete if the heart does not believe and the mouth speaks. If your heart believes alone and your mouth does not speak it, it's not a complete and total salvation. Salvation is for you to become everything that God wants you to be, and for you to have freedom and deliverance from everything that holds you captive. That mountain will move. If you want it to move, believe it will move, and speak it. It moves, and it will move, even now, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I wrap up by saying this. The day you have something in its external reality was not the day it was made to happen. It had been programmed to happen before the day it became real. So which means that you are not seeing it now does not mean the programming has not been put into effect by your belief system and by your spoken words. My God, it is said that when a rock breaks, it is not just the 1,000,000th time or 1,000th time, the 1,000th time that they hit the rock with an iron or with a hammer that breaks it. No, it's all of the previous times that they've been hitting the rock. That's what breaks it. That you have not seen it break does not mean it's not going to break. You have put in motion what will make it break. By speaking to that mountain, non-stop, not losing faith, you have put in motion the thing that will make that mountain to move. Just believe it and keep at it, not changing your confession, not changing your beliefs, and you shall see what your heart desires. In Jesus' name, I bless you today, and I decree you can have and you will have whatsoever you believe and whatsoever you say. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So therefore, be careful not to say the wrong things, because whatever comes out of your mouth becomes your external realities. May the God of heaven bless you, cause his face to shine upon you, be gracious unto you, and do you good. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I never close the broadcast without having you to declare words of affirmation. And those words of affirmation must be positive words. Saying, Lord, I believe. I am blessed. Lord, I believe. I am prosperous. Lord, I believe that this mountain is gone out of my presence. Ah, Lord, I believe, like Moses declared, the Egyptians that you see today, you shall see them no more. So be it in my life that every hindering power, every force of the wicked, and have stood against me, they shall nowhere be found after now, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, I believe that victory is mine, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, I believe I am blessed and the blessed of the Lord. I am prosperous. I'm a lender, not a borrower. I'm the head, not the tail. I'm above only and not beneath. Goodness, mercy follows me all the days of my life, and I'll dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever, in Jesus' name. Wow! The Lord bless you, and the Lord do good unto you at all times, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Never forget, you can have and you will have whatsoever you say, based on a heart, a mindset that is resolute, not flaky, not shaky, in Jesus' mighty name. Press that like button and share this message with friends and families alike. And you too can go with me to to my YouTube channel, Bishop Mike Ladu TV, and subscribe, so that every time we put a post, you can always get the message. The Lord bless you. Till I come your way same time tomorrow, which is 12 noon. Never forget, every day for you will be a plus and not a minus. In Jesus' mighty name. Stay rapturable. I'll see you by 12. Knowing this, that you and I must constantly see only things that we want to see manifest in our lives. God bless you. In Jesus' name.